witness. She was the one that said, hey, we got people who have questions. You know, they're getting a little frustrated. They don't quite know what to say when they're reaching out. So I thought, you know what? Let's get on a Zoom and let's chat about this. So I am recording it so that you can send it out to your teams and really talk about different ways. Now, all of you guys know today is the second of the month. So that means you actually have almost three full calendar months to hit the Ruby bonus. So basically this month is an added awesome bonus month. So you have all April, all May, all June to hit your $500 Ruby bonus. So it's really, really important that as you reach out to people today, you let them know that today is a very, very awesome special day to get started with their It Works business. So that's the number one thing that we all hopefully have seen the promotions for this month. They're not double this month, but they are single. So at least we still have some promotions to work towards. And I don't know if you saw on Team Mentor, but we talked a lot about making sure that you really work these first 10 days as being the most important part of your month. Do not delay on these days. These days are crucial to what your April will finish like. So for sure, get your game face on, get your action plan together, talk with your teams if you have teams, and get a plan in place to make this an awesome, awesome month. That's the second thing. The third thing, if you're frustrated, so if you're frustrated in your business and you're reaching out to people and you feel frustrated, I can tell you from personally developing yourself, if you're reaching out while you're frustrated, you will bring more frustration to yourself. So that's the first thing you need to step back and say, oh, okay, well, if my head is not right, my mindset is not right, my heart is not right, knowing what a gift I have here in this business, you won't be successful as you're reaching out to people today if you're in that frustrated mindset. So that's the number one thing. If you don't change your mindset, your business is not going to grow. Okay, so that's really, really, really huge. So you need to maybe take a walk, maybe get on the treadmill, maybe take an hour off and get your mind actually into maybe some really good personal development. That's the first thing you need to do. Something I would suggest is Bob Proctor. Go on YouTube, look up Bob Proctor and watch something personal development from his, you know, anything about mindset to help you, because you will not grow your business in a frustrated state. You won't. It doesn't happen. So that's the first thing. The second thing is, let's talk about like maybe some of the things you are saying to people as you're reaching out to people. So does anybody want to start by unmuting themselves that might be at, you know, hitting a wall, trying to figure out, you know, why they're not getting good response or maybe not getting a good message back? Besides the fact that I said, if you're frustrated, stop reaching out to people if you're frustrated at this very moment and get in a better mindset first and then start again. Unmute yourself if there's anybody that's like totally in that spot that needs help.
So I have a lot of my team members that are in that spot. I have certain girls that like to just only do cold messaging, and they're hitting a brick wall where they're getting a lot of no's. And then a lot of my new distributors, they are reaching out to their warm market and are getting frustrated because they thought that, you know, they were going to have the support and have people order from them, and they're getting the no's. And I'm just wondering what type of verbiage I can relate to them to overcome those no's and to maybe like go back to those people, or just to get new verbiage to reach out to new people and start over.
Awesome. One thing, when I started in my business, I did not actually start messaging my friends. I didn't. Or excuse me, my family. I did not expect my family to be the one to make my business go. So that's one thing I think we all should really maybe step back a little bit and say, well, just because I'm starting a business, it doesn't mean that I should expect my family members and my best friends to get on board with me. Really, honestly, we really can't expect that they're the ones that are going to make our business go. Now, along the way, they may join up. They may message you out. Maybe you do have a great supportive family that will jump on right with you. But don't be upset or think that this business isn't going to work for you if your family and your closest friends say, no, I'm not interested. So So that's one thing I think we really have to really think about. And I just don't believe that you know, that's where I think direct sales gets a bad rap. Because as soon as somebody starts on, they start hounding their family and friends to be the ones that make their business go. I think we can't do that, guys.
You just said bad rap. That's
pretty bad. Right? Bad rap. So honestly, that's one thing I would say, Amanda, to let your teammates know. And then as far as one thing I'm going to ask is, when you're reaching out to people, are you truly reaching out to help them with their issues and looking for a way to help them produce a result for what they're looking for? See, sometimes
in other words, are we aiming to bring them value in everything we do? Like today, when we're on this Zoom, it's our goal. It's our top goal is to bring you guys value. It's not our goal to walk away from this Zoom today and have brought value to ourselves, even though we're listening to you guys and we're trying to pick up tips from you guys as you're speaking as well. It's our goal to bring you guys value, something you can walk away with, something you can solve your problems with.
Yeah, so as you're reaching out to people, are you making it about them or are you making it about you? Because if you're making it about you, then it's not about them, and they can sense that. They know that, and they're saying, well, you just want a sale off of me. They can sense that in every single aspect of no matter how you word things. So make it about them. Write that down. When I reach out, I need to make it about them. I'm writing it down myself because I need to remind myself of that. Not about my promotion. Not about my four little customers that I need for my first 30 days. Not about, you know, what I need. But what do they need? What do they need? John Maxwell says several times in business, in his personal development books, John Maxwell says, if you help enough other people get what they want, you will get what you want. Another thing he says, which I love, is people do not care how much you know until they know how much you care. Do you understand that? That's huge. People do not care how much you know until they know how much you care. So when you're reaching out to people, make sure that you're making it about them and helping them get to where they need to go, whether that's weight loss goals, whether that's, you know, improved health in whatever way. Maybe that's helping them get their, you know, $500 bonus that they're going after. Does that help a little bit, Amanda? Did that answer some of your questions?
Yeah, that does help a lot.
Okay. So when they're reaching out, some things that we could be saying. So maybe some of you are saying, well, what could we say? First of all, you can't be in a frustrated state. So you need to write down, I need to be in a really good frame of mind when I'm reaching out to people. I need to be in a thankful state, not in a what can people do for me state. It's what can I do for others state is what we need to have for our mindset. And then second of all is making it about them, not about ourselves. So what are some things that you guys have been saying as you've been reaching out? I know we've got scripts. We've got that whole thread of scripts. I know we've got the scripts up in the Team Enter that we can look at, that and word choice documents up there as well. What are some things that you guys are saying that we can maybe help Amanda and her team with that are working for you?
Sorry, I'm going to try to just tell you guys what we've been doing for our team. I hope it's not too loud. But one thing that we really do and we really focus on is when we reach out to our people, we pick out those people that are looking to lose weight, and then we tell them about the ThermoFit, the greens. We go out and we reach out for those people that have back pain, and we just start talking about that one product instead of promoting, hey, why don't you order something from me or check out my website? We always focus on what people need help with. Like Liz said, if you make it about them and say, hey, I have this relief, try it out. It's an all-natural product. It will really help with your back pain. And I'm just looking for true testimonials. I would love it if you would just give it a shot. And once you make it, like Liz said, make it about them, then it'll be like, oh, wow, you know, maybe I will. So focusing on one product that will help someone that needs help with it. Is what's really been working for our team.
I love that. So did you guys all write that down? So you're focusing on helping them. What's working for them is choosing a product and then messaging with those people about that particular product. You know, the relief for the back pain or for weight loss. Summer's around the corner. What are we, 11 weeks away? So she said about ThermoFit and greens and that. Those two things together, which would be a couple products. But definitely specific things that you're maybe asking them about would be a really, really great thing to think about. I'm just trying to think, like when you're just cold messaging people, I'm just trying to think in my head.
We had the question that we were using when we were at the vendor event, and I said about, you know, stump me with your issue.
Struggle.
Because I was talking with Lexi this morning. I said, everybody has something that they're dealing with in their life, whether it's a health issue or a financial struggle, everybody is working with something. And so I think when we develop that personal relationship with them, that's what I would hone in on is what can you, because here's the thing, when people have a struggle, people love to get together over a struggle. They somehow, the walls come down when you guys can work together on fixing a struggle. Mm-hmm. And so I think you're right on it, Steph. I mean, get together with people, figure out what their struggle is. Even if it takes sitting down and having a couple beers or whatever, and they start talking about what's bothering them the most. And then you can go from there.
Okay. That's awesome, Stephanie. Thank you. What else does anybody that's working for them as they're reaching out? And remember, you're not reaching out in a frustrated state. You're reaching out in a so glad to help you state. I'm so thankful I have the ability and I have this gift of this business to help people with their ailments or their financial problems. That's what we do. We specialize in that. Okay. Who else has a question or has something that they want to talk about? Becky, go ahead.
Okay, so I have a question. I have one of my new distributors, Cassie. She's got several potential distributors. And the problem that she's running into is that they're asking her, like, well, and I've had a few potential distributors too that I'm actually struggling with this on, where they say, well, I've tried to be, I was a distributor once with It Works and it didn't work. And I wasn't successful. And I don't want to come back with Adam with the obvious, like, well, then you didn't work your business. You know what I mean? I don't want to come across as angry because I'm not angry at my business right now. I'm super excited. But, you know, like how to come at them like, you know, well, I good luck to you and your business, but this just isn't for me. I've already tried it before. And, you know, I was in for a year and I couldn't get past executive. And like I said, my obvious answer right away was, well, duh, you're not working. You didn't work your business, you know? And then I actually had one of my new loyal customers come to me the other day and said, she has had, she's a fellow police wife and she's had 8 other distributors come at her. And she said, I was the only one that actually seemed to care. She said, everybody else, it was more like she sees what they're doing. They're trying to get motion. She's like, and I've seen the charts. I've Googled it. She's like, so I feel like they were coming at me just for me to fill a box for them so they can get a promotion. But I've, like I said, I've had some potential distributors that are like, you know, I would love to do again, but I don't want the $99 again because I know I can't be successful at it. So are those people that we just give up on or what do we do?
So I would start by saying, or by, instead of trying to answer their question, I would ask them a question and say, so why do you think you weren't successful in the business?
A lot of them tell me though, it's because, well, you have to actually, you have to go out there and get like so many customers and you have to bring on distributors and it's just, I can't get loyal customers. And a lot of them too are saying that they didn't have a good upline. They didn't have support. Somebody would sign them to fill a box to get their promotion and then left them alone.
Sure. Well, I think that those cases you would need to handle individually. Where, you know, for example, someone comes to you and says they didn't have good leadership. I would say, okay, we can definitely work with that. I mean, you have me. I mean, I'm talking about you, Becky. You can say you have me. I'm a plugged in leader. I'm growing. I've showed growth and development over the past 3 months. Our team is definitely, we have resources and personal development, and we're going places. We have the proof is in the pudding in that.
And this is what I would say. I would ask them, are you coachable? I would flat out just say, are you coachable? Would you like to give this a round two with me? I would just simply say that. You know, and really a person can be in any business. You know, it's funny, you watch people's patterns, they like come to this business and they maybe don't, they aren't successful here, and then they start another new business that comes into town or a new direct sales, and then they go over there and they just aren't successful there, and then they quit and they go to a third business and after a while you have to turn inward and go, I have a pattern going on here. Well, maybe it's me.
They find out what the common denominator is.
Right.
And all that.
So if you don't personally develop yourself, and talking with everybody on this Zoom and ourselves included, you cannot miss personal development in this business. You will put a lid on yourself and you will put a lid on your team. Your mindset has to become continually expanded and stretched so that you can continually believe and achieve as you keep moving forward. Because believe you me, we all get hung up in certain places and it keeps us stuck. Keeps us stuck exactly where we are. Or we have a pattern that keeps happening and you're like, why does this keep happening? And then you have to turn inward and say, it's me. It's not anybody else. It's me. There's something I need to work on. Until I fix that, I'll continually have that same pattern happening over and over and over again. So even with your brand new people, if you're brand new on this Zoom, you need to even do just 10 minutes of personal development. If you have 10 minutes every day, everybody has 10 minutes. You have to personally develop yourself. You can not personally develop yourself and not go anywhere in this business. And if you spent 10 minutes a day or 20 or 30 or sometimes an hour, I need, because that's just the state of mind that I'm in, that funk, that hour alone will make my month, my year way different and better and more improved and growing than if I sat there and said, I don't need personal development. No, I don't need it. And then you just keep cycling the same thing over and over and over again. So, and getting nowhere, you know?
So let me ask you this. I can't remember. I want to make sure I don't give misinformation. I was thinking about two, maybe coming at them with the approach of, was it Cammy that came in once and left and then came back again?
Yeah.
What was that story again?
She joined and quit. I don't know. Was it two or three times? Yeah. And then when she finally stuck with it, it was 6 months before she hired her first distributor on.
Okay.
Yeah. And for us, like, we joined and we didn't bring on a single distributor for 4 months. You know why? Because I had the mindset of, I don't want to build a team. I'm not going to build a team. I'm not going to build a team. And guess what? I didn't build a team.
I think
it's catchy. I just want to say, like, I'm working with someone. She, like, same thing, tried it, didn't have, a good relationship with her upline, wasn't, in the same area, wasn't whatever helpful in her words. And I just told her, like, don't let your first time determine your success this time around. And unfortunately, she has to wait the 90 days, and I don't know. Well, 90 days is up this month, so we'll see if she actually signs. But, like, the first time around doesn't matter. Like, she's going to start out scratch, from the start with a new team, new leadership, new whatever, So just make sure she knows that.
Awesome. Thank you.
Another thing, Becky, I'm glad you brought that up, because that exactly happened to us last month. One of my new distributors signed up, and we had a girl there who used to be a distributor about a year ago, and she said it didn't work for her, da-di-da-di-da. The very first thing I asked her was, did your upline help you? And she says, well, yes, but not ready, but not really. And she was like, I've been contemplating about coming back. I just want a good team. So when you are trying to turn someone else around when they've already joined, already been in It Works and didn't work for them a second time, show them the success of our team. Tell them about our Zooms all the time. Tell them about our trainings. Tell them about all the calls that we do. And once they know that they will not be left behind, that kind of gets their wheel turning, thinking, okay, maybe this time around will work. Like, use John and Liz's example, how she got John home. look at everybody on our teams that got all of these bonuses and say, you could be part of our success. We don't leave anybody behind. So once you make a point of that, like, we will help you. We will do everything that we can. Then they really get to thinking again that, okay, maybe I can get this second round, you know, going again.
Thank you.
I think, I love that, Stephanie. And I think really it's, you have to put it in, you have to have the person come up with the ownership themselves, asking the questions to get the right answer. So I don't promise anything to anyone. I do say, are you coachable? And then if they are, and if they're willing to pass the basketball back and forth with me, then I'll work with them. If they're not willing to do that, I let them know up front that I will not pass the basketball back and forth. I will not chase. I will not chase. You have to want this for yourself as much as I want it for you. It's unfortunate. Unfortunately, we can't pull everybody up the hill with us. We can work with those that want to be worked with. And if they are coachable and they're willing to do what's necessary, then by golly jeepers, they can have all the success in the world, you know?
And Denise Walsh, I know she just said recently too, she said, you know, I'm excellent at returning phone calls, you know, texts, whatever. But she said, I'm not a good stalker. Mm-hmm. She said, so if the person is going to sort of play this game where they just get lost and they, you know, you reach out to them and you can't ever hear back for them, she's not a good stalker that way. Mm-hmm. And I would, I think what all of you are trying to get at here is you have to develop that personal confidence with yourselves that what you have is so earth shattering, so groundbreaking, so off the cuff here. The bonuses, we were just talking about this with somebody here today. There are no other companies out there that are celebrating bonuses and have Facebook buzz like we do. None. There's not a single other company out there. I don't care about the ones that are even in our realm that are close to us. None of them are shouting out bonuses like we are. We have something special. So that being said, you guys need to own that and have confidence in that. And that confidence really goes to what Liz just said, in that when you're talking with a new potential distributor and that distributor is kind of giving you the runaround, oh, yeah, I tried this. You need to own that with them and say, hey,
speak truth.
Like Stephanie said, if you want to join a winning team, we have a winning team here. But the thing that needs to be different about this time is you. If you want to be successful in this business, you need to be different. And that's inside of you.
So then you say to them, are you willing to get on our calls? We have weekly calls. Are you willing to, you know, how much time are you willing to dedicate to your business? Because we have to be real here. We can't act as though this is like a cakewalk.
Well, in the end, what's going to happen is what you guys are kind of voicing right now is you're a little bit scared that if you say the wrong thing, that the relationship might be over with. They might go with somebody else's team. But the reality of it is, they're going to respect you for your rawness and your upfrontness with them. They're going to respect that. They're going to say, you know what? This person takes their business seriously. I can see that. They have a serious team who believes in giving people the training and the team camaraderie that we're looking for here. And so I believe that if you're upfront and you're bold and you're confident about those things, they're going to respect you for it. Mm-hmm. And if you do get someone who turns aside and goes the other direction, A, they're going to find out that the next team probably doesn't have what they're looking for anyway. And B, it was them in the first place, and it was probably better that they weren't on your team.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, so what other questions do we have? What other things are you thinking about? You know, I think coming from such a certainty of what we have to offer is very, very important. No matter what scripts you have, I love when people say you can never say the wrong thing to the right person, and vice versa. You can never say the right thing to the wrong person. So no matter that we have these awesome scripts that are all up in there, what's behind all those scripts? Is there passion in your belly? Is there fire within? Is there an unquenchable just certainty that you have without a shadow of a doubt the most amazing business opportunity and products? You will get no's in this business. I'll say it again. You will get no's in this business. We need to train our people. You're going to get lots of no's in this business, right? But you're looking for the yeses. I love when Pam Sauter says, not everyone likes mustard. Not everyone likes mustard. Don't take it personally. They just don't care for mustard. And most of the time, those no's are usually just not yet. They'll come as they watch your success. So you go out and gather your four yeses, your four loyal customers, your step two, and your step three of your distributors. You be the rock star that you're looking for. You be that person.
And that will attract the right crowd. This is all about attraction marketing, guys. Mm-hmm. You put off the vibration or the vibe that you're looking for. And it goes back to what Liz started with, if you're sowing seeds in frustration, you're going to reap in frustration. I know that sounds too simple, but
it's true.
You listen to a little bit of Bob Proctor and you're very quickly going to figure this out. It's really quite simple.
Okay, what other questions do we have? Anyone, anything? There's not a dumb question or a... I love it. We are listening to, you should all watch The Secret. I don't know if you've seen The Secret, and that is about Bob Proctor is in that, but it's an actual kind of movie documentary type thing. It's called The Secret. And isn't that where he talks about the two different people?
No, that's actually The Slight Edge.
Oh, that's another one, The Slight Edge. But he talks about how two people can come into this business. Two people, exactly. Same opportunity, $99 kit. Same products. We all have them, you know? Same thing. And why is it that one person...
Well, the people even look like they could be pretty close to the same. They look the same.
Right.
You know, they drive pretty much the same car. They live on the same street.
Why is it that one goes... And the other one goes... You know what I mean? And so what does he say in that, The Slight Edge?
Well, enough things that we do that are mediocre things along the way will either make us successful, or they can be the difference between being successful or not being successful. And The Slight Edge is, it's great because it's a free audio. You can go on there and you can listen to it if you're in the car, if you got your half hour a day, whatever. I think it's like 3 hours long, maybe, tops. But I think it's a little bit of real talk is what it is. It's a little real talk of what you really need to hear. What you do now in your life when you're young is going to mean the exponential difference in the outcomes that you're looking for later on in your life. That's why we always hear, don't put off till tomorrow what you can do today. Because today is the only thing you're guaranteed. You're not guaranteed tomorrow, and you sure as heck can't change what you did yesterday. So living and doing the things in the moment of right now are the only things that you're in control of. If things got serious for any one of you, whether it be health or finance or anything, wouldn't you want to know that you are doing the things right now that could truly change something in your life, or that it was enough, that you wouldn't look back on your time that you had so-called wasted and said, I wish I would have done more? Now is that time. And reading some of these self-development books have given us that edge, if you will.
You know, what are you speaking over yourself to? Do you have your I ams every single day? People think that's so corny and they say, oh my goodness, I'm not going to say like I am this, I am that every day. But even in the Bible, in Proverbs, it says, as a man thinks, so is he. So if you are thinking, I can't get loyal customers, guess what? You will not get loyal customers. If you are thinking, I cannot get distributors, then you in fact will not get distributors. Do you know that what you think and what you speak is what will manifest? It will come about. What you bring about is what you think about, you bring about. Okay? So what are you saying? When you pick up your phone, you're saying to yourself, I am a loyal customer magnet. I attract loyal customers like flies on
paper.
Paper. not a paper. What do they like to come to? I don't even know what flies like to be here. Fleas to stink. Yeah.
White on rice.
Yeah. So for distributors, you know, you get ready to message, and you get your mindset set up that I'm going to sign up 5 distributors today. You just get that mindset going. And sure enough, maybe you'll sign up 1 or 2, as opposed to being frustrated every single day and saying, I'm just not good enough. I won't ever get anywhere. Then that's what's going to happen for you too.
Well, and you're going to reaffirm your beliefs when, you know, if you tell yourself, I'm not any good at this business. You know, Liz, she's done awesome at this business, and I just stink. Well, guess what? When I go out today and I don't talk to anybody, or if I do, and the next person looks at me like, well, you don't look like you're having fun, and so I'm not going to join you in this business. And then I tell myself at the end of the day, I go, see, I told myself I wasn't very good. And see, that person even made fun of me for being in this business. So everything I've been telling myself is exactly true. So I just reaffirm what I was thinking to myself in the very beginning. Now, all we're asking you is, it doesn't take any more energy to think one way than it does another. It doesn't take any more energy to think I can do it versus I can't. But look at the difference in the results that you get. When I say, look at, I can do it, I will not stop until I find a way. And then when you find a way, those results give you the reaffirmation that you've been looking for, which gives you the gas power to go and hit it again the next day. And it just feeds off of itself. Whereas your negative energy will do just the absolute opposite, but the same. It will feed off of those negative results that you get, and it'll just manifest itself into one big spiral in the downward, and you will end up failing in the end. Does that make sense, guys?
It's mindset. At the end of the day,
mindset.
I don't care. You could throw, you know, whatever out there. You can throw whatever out there. But if it's in a negative, you can have the most amazing message and script that you believe that you scripted to the best thing that you send out. You're like, wow, look at this. But if it's in a frustrated, negative mindset, it will not do you any good.
I've been trying to figure something else out. You know, we get these people that say, oh, you know, the rap didn't work. I knew that wasn't going to work. Right? And yet, we've got these people that get on here and they're like, oh my goodness, look at what this rap did for me in just 2 hours. I knew this thing worked. I just had to try it for myself. And I always say to Liz, look at the difference in the two of those things. And could you believe that the rap working and not working might just come down to mindset? And we're all sitting here, when we put the rap on, people were like, yeah, I was hoping and praying that thing would work better than ever before. But it all came down to the person's mindset. You know, do you know that the energy that you start in your mind manifests itself through your body so that things work out one way or another? I mean, your body, your mind has the power to tell your body to be well or to be sick. I was just telling the kids today, I said, there is no such thing as a good day or a bad day. The day all by itself is the same whether you look at it this way or that way. It's all in your mind whether or not you're having a good day or a bad day. I said, which kind of day do you want to have? Decide which day you want to have, and then go make it that way.
Good stuff. Okay, what other questions do you guys have?
Yeah.
I have some questions with my distributors that, like, don't have kids or can relate to, you know, like single moms that they're trying to talk to about signing up in the business. So how would you recommend to have a conversation with somebody in that aspect that is having a hard time relating to the other person?
So you're saying some of your friends are trying to reach out to people who have children or vice versa? Like one would be a mom reaching out to somebody who's single.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I think that, you know, you can start always with, again, trying to just ask them, you know, if there's any, you know, like John said, you know, maybe when you're reaching out to them first, you can just talk to them about, you know, if they've ever heard of It Works, you can start there, you know, and then I think it's that conversation, that relationship that you build. Help me out, John, a little bit with a single mom.
Well, I definitely think you're going to build relationships. The thing that I hear right off the bat is, you know, I'm a guy, and yet I've learned over 4 years that I don't steer away from a single gal with children just because I don't relate to her in the exact setup of my family. I relate to her as a person to another person. I relate to her as a person who I know I was struggling with money at one time. I know that I was struggling to spend more time with my family at one time. And I make it more about the broad sense in that way. I don't necessarily make it about she's a single gal, I'm a married man. I guess I don't necessarily think it about that way. I don't break it down in my mind that, oh, if it came to rapping, I wouldn't be able to put a rap on her because I'm a guy, she's a girl, you know, this, that, and the other. I make it about the connecting on a human standpoint.
And connecting with the two things we offer, right? We offer health and wellness, which everyone's looking for. You know, more energy, feeling better, less stress, losing weight, whatever that might be. And the second thing is financially. So we can find a connection no matter where they are, what walk of life, yeah, what their family situation dynamic is or not, simply through two things, health and wellness, what we offer, and then helping them with finances, with the opportunity.
I know Kyler Pentecost said, you know, it's as weird as you make it. You know, don't make there be a struggle there, you know, like don't make there be some sort of a roadblock between the two of you that doesn't exist. We're all human. We all have problems, whether it's health or financial. You know, build a relationship around those things and offer hope.
Does that help some?
Yeah, I think that's going to help them a lot.
Okay.
Cool.
Anything else, guys?
I have a question. So we've been talking a little bit about personal development. I have a question, kind of a poll question. Who would be game for if we would take some time and start kind of a book club where we would start going through a book a few chapters at a time, whatever. I don't know what kind of a venue, if it would happen over Zoom, if it would happen over Periscope. Who of you think that you or you know, someone you know on your team could benefit from something like that if we started something like that?
I would like to have something like that.
Okay.
Because they say in this business, this type of style of business is you are paid according to your personal development. So we call it a compensation plan attached to your, personal development plan attached to your compensation plan. We're going to say something?
I would be interested too.
Awesome.
I'm game.
And I think even if you just meet for 20 minutes, you know what I mean? If we just met for 20 minutes, you know, to talk through what we learned and what we, you know, learned through that. Because we can't miss that piece. I think people think that's the thing we're going, and we realize that's the thing we needed the most. Like, we hit a wall in a big, big way. And why was that? Because we didn't believe that we had time to develop ourselves. Isn't that crazy? We believed we did not have time to develop ourselves. And what we found was our business was not going anywhere till we grew ourselves personally.
Well, and I have an analogy that can go with that. You know, if you were going to swim across the English Channel, don't you think it would be advantageous for you to, number one, have learned how to swim, and number two, have built up your stamina to do so? Because desire alone won't get it done. Awesome. Well, we'll look at... We will look at what book we're going to start with, and then we'll look at, hopefully figuring out the best time that we can accommodate. We'll probably end up doing it over Zoom, I would say, just because if it's a club and we want to have feedback, that's probably the best venue. I know Cammie has done, she did kind of a book club over Periscope, but that was more of a one-way deal, and I know people could chat in, but I think it's beneficial for us to hear each other and see each other too. So we'll look for feedback from you guys on that. as we get that set up.
Would you be able to give us like the book title and then like give us 2 weeks before we do the first thing? That way we all have time to get the book in like from Amazon.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and I'm even thinking off the top of my head what we would start with. I think I'm going to think about it a little bit. I mean, the first book that came to my mind was maybe Eat That Frog, because I know a lot of people got that book. But we're going to talk, Liz and I will talk about it a little bit, just for what we think would maybe be the best book to get everybody started. If this is your first personal development book, you know, what would be most impactful? So maybe we'll just think about that a little bit. Another one that's maybe on the tip of my mind is like Earl Nightingale's The Strangest Secret. That's a really short read, and it's like a $3 book if you had to buy it. So that might be another possibility too.
Mm-hmm. Any other thoughts or anything with reaching out to people, script ideas? Like I said, there are scripts like crazy. You know, I know a lot of the leaders are in a thread that's called Scripts to Send Out. They can copy and paste it. Just ask your leader for that. And then there's stuff up in the file section on both Team Enter and on Tribe to print out that has all the scripts in the world. But like I said, you can't say the wrong thing to the right person nor the right thing to the wrong person. It comes down to the passion, the confidence, the certainty that you have as you reach out to people, knowing that you are going to get no's, but every no is going to get you closer to the yes. So, and then those no's, a lot of times, they just need to be invited 8 to 12 times more. So don't give up on those no's, ever. Keep adding them to your hundreds list. Any last thoughts, guys? Otherwise, I'm going to start reaching out and doing my power hour. I like to do a power hour every single day where I set a timer and just get reaching out to people. And especially today with April 2nd going on with the added third month with the $500 bonus for those that join. So that's an awesome thing as well to get started with. All right, guys, anything else? Amanda?
Yeah, I just had one last thing, because I had a lot of new distributors that just started building their teams, and they were going back into their e-suite and kind of trying to figure out their commissions and stuff like that. So they were wondering what commission qualify meant and, you know, what they were getting commissions off of as far as, like, their team and their customers. So if you could just kind of, like, generalize that to them so that they can understand a little bit better and know what to look for this coming up month as well and how to set themselves up to be prepared for that, that would be helpful.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, first of all, I always suggest that people, the first thing you do is you know, you don't spend a whole lot of time reading through because you want to get your business going. Action is huge in this business to get momentum flowing, right? Getting your loyal customers and distributors. But if you want to know exactly the logistics of exactly how the whole comp plan works, we have a compensation plan document in your document library in your e-suite. It says comp plan. You can print it out. I don't know. It's 20-some pages long. There's also a couple YouTube videos that Denise Walsh, she's a Black Diamond, Denise Walsh, she put together, and there's one that's for basic comp plan, and there's one for advanced. And what we did is we just kept listening to it every so often. That would be our personal development for the day. And we would just got more and more familiar with it as we moved through. But your questions here for, you know, if you see when you log in and it says, you know, 66% distributor, and you just got started, and you're like, well, what's going on? So until what you have at least 150 in personal bonus volume or running your ADBV auto shipment, which ADBV is what we strongly encourage, because how can you be in a business and not be using the products and becoming a product of your product? But once you hit 150 PBV or run an ADBV and you have do you have your four loyal customers? I forget. Two makes you fast start qualified. So when you see FSQ with a check mark, that means you're fast start qualified when you get two loyal customers in your first 30 days. And then commission qualified is just 150 in personal bonus volume or running your ADBV auto shipment. Now, when you're fast start qualified, that means now you, when you bring on your first distributor and they gather their first two loyal customers, you get a $100 Fast Start bonus. They have to have 115 PBV or running their ADBV. Again, strongly encouraging the ADBV, not just 150 in personal bonus volume. So, were you going
to
say something?
But to get to the point as far as these people wanting to figure out, you know, if you're wanting to point blank figure out your check, I am going to tell you that that is a waste of time. And I respectfully say that. But what I want you to know is what Liz said is right. You want to go into the comp plan, and you want to look, for example, that, you know, when you get to be Diamond, for example, you are going to add, you're going to add the generational bonus, which is going to give you an 80. For any new person that comes on into your team and gets Fast Start qualified, you're going to get an 80 for that. It goes through all of those extra ways that you're going to make money in this business. But what I am trying to say is, if you are trying to figure out your exact commission and try and like check up on, maybe you're trying to check up on the corporate to see if they paid you the correct amount, that's you're don't try and be an accountant because that's not going to work. I have never in almost 4 years gone back and tried to recalculate what corporate is coming up with for my paycheck, because there's no way that you can possibly chase that all down. As your business continues to grow and get more complicated, and where the distributors are and what levels they're on, there's just no possible way. Now, that being said, if you are an executive, what they need to know is that anybody that they personally enroll, they get a 5% bonus on for personally enrolling someone, whether that be a distributor or a loyal customer. If you have a loyal customer and a distributor, anybody that's on your top two lines, that's 10% commissions paid off of those and 5% added to that for personally enrolled. So that's 15% on your first two lines is the max you can make for that, right? Then it goes 10, 10, 5, 5. So 5% for the third and fourth, and then 2 to infinity when you qualify for those extra levels to be paid on those. So, you know, that's the comp plan in a nutshell. But again, you know, respectfully, the way you get paid in this business is to go out and get loyal customers and distributors and really essentially build yourself up to the Diamond level first. And then, you know, really the commission plan, gets the craziest at Triple Diamond is where you really get qualified to get paid the craziest amount of money. And then obviously it goes up from there. But I hope that answers some questions on that. I just don't want people to be too green and trying to figure out what their paycheck is going to be. They've got people in the
And you know what? When I first started our first month, my first paycheck, because I started just like everyone else did almost 4 years ago in October, I had like a 67. Like a $67 my first month paycheck, but my wrap cash was over $1,000. I was wrapping everyone and signing up as loyal customers and I didn't sign any distributors for 4 months again, because I said, I'm not going to sign any distributors. And so therefore I spoke that, thought that, and didn't sign any distributors. So we all grow and we all move depending on what work you're doing. You know, what's your action? You know, what are you doing to build your business every single day? You're paid accordingly, according to what you do.
I understand, though, where that line of thinking comes from, because honestly, in the corporate world, we really get sort of, you know, they train us to look at what we do and get paid off of what we do. But the honest truth about it is, in this business, our income goes up exponentially when we help the next person. And you really, because I love this question when someone says to me, well, you brought in a distributor, you brought in a loyal customer in the first week of your business. And they say, what was that worth to you on ROI? And I'm like, I love that question, because I say it's a ripple effect. It's like dropping a stone in the water 1 year and having that still create ripples down the road. We've got stones dropped in our pool when we first started almost four years ago, and those are still getting to be bigger today. There's the exponential growth and the income that's making today is still growing. So in that respect, you could never fully calculate, you know, what your commissions were and where that was going to translate from month one to, you know, 20 years down the road. Does that help, Amanda? I know that was kind of a stretched out explanation.
Yeah, I think that's going to help my team.
Awesome.
Yes, and so don't leave those $100 fast start bonuses on the table. You know what I mean? Work those steps to success. And when you bring on distributors, make sure you're helping them gather their loyal customers within their first 30 days so that you can make sure that once they get the two, you get your 100. And you can place loyal customers too. You know, we help to do that too in organizations here and there. You know, if I bring somebody on and they have one and then I have another, then we have great communication about that to have that teamwork happening and not to ever leave $100 just on the table and don't take it. So we really train that out. And at our level, Triple Diamond, we're not only just making $100
off of a personally enrolled.
Personally enrolled, but then we also get, you know how you get the 80 at Diamond, you get an additional 80 and then like 40 at double and then like a 20, I think.
So it comes out to 135.
135. So that's triple. Huge when you think of each person in your organization with those fast start bonuses and those are called cab bonuses as you get to be diamond and above. So we're not going to get too much into that, but just don't leave money on the table and work with your teams. Make sure that everybody knows
and
you joined on, you have 30 days, step success, really keep working with them.
And the one other thing I want to mention too is just that as we're going through bonus season here, I think it's important that you remind your teams that bonus season is awesome. I mean, it's super fine, right? It's extra cash on top. But don't work your business thinking, if I don't get a bonus, I'm done. I'm out of here. Because if you're just working for the bonus, you're missing the big picture. This business has so much more to offer, so much life legacy with the comp plan all by itself. The bonuses are just, you know, frosting carrots on top of the frosting.
Well, carrots.
And
those
so
only last for 25 months. And then after that, they're gone.
We want to teach you how to max out the comp plan all by itself. And then if you get a bonus, that's super fine.
Any last questions, guys?
All right.
So it's April 2nd. So 8 more days to really, I mean, obviously you're going to work the whole month strong, but these first 10 days, I believe, are the most important to see what your month end, how your month end is going to finish. So make sure that you have a goal in place, that you have written down where you are going. You've talked with your team to set a plan in place to move this forward. Because they always say where your focus is, that forms your future. Where you steer is where you stare. Where you steer is where you steer. So, you know, and the other one that is what? If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. So you do need to get an action plan in place. Where there is no vision, the people perish. They go away. So set up that plan as leaders for your team and get them on course to work together to get your goals all taken care of, everybody's, by month end. All right. Well, this is awesome, Amanda. Thank you so much for suggesting, you know, in the thread about, you know, having some questions. And then we got on this Zoom. So that's awesome. All right. I'll get the recording out. I'll put it in the leadership thread. You guys can throw it out to wherever you want to throw it out to your teams. And maybe this will have some good tips for people as well. But remember, mindset is number one. If you are coming from a frustrated state, if you are not in the proper mindset of wanting to, again, remember, you're taking the focus off of you as you reach out and you're putting the focus on them. How can I help you? Not how can you help me? How can I help you? I have these products. I have this business opportunity. How can I help you with these two things? Any last thoughts, guys? All right. You guys have an awesome rest of your day and love to hear how everybody's doing. And let's rock this month out. Okay, guys?
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Love y'all. God bless.